Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Q, and you guys know, everybody knows that I'm obsessed with this new DAX query view. And somebody called me out on it. They were like, Patrick, you're telling me you can write queries in DAX? I thought it was an expression language that returns scalar values. I'm like, no. Queries in the title. Think about, wait. Enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do? Let's go write some DAX queries. So the first thing you need to do is enable the preview feature if you want to do this in the desktop. So you need to go enable DAX query view. If you're using DAX Studio or Management Studio, you don't need to do anything. You just pop over to that tool and you start writing your queries. I'm going to do it all in Power BI Desktop because I like the new DAX query view so much. Once it's enabled, pop over to the new DAX query view. You'll be presented with the query. And to write your first DAX query, you'll be presented with query one. You must use the evaluate. At the most basic level, it would be evaluate containing a table. So for example, if I do internet sales, it's going to run and it's going to return all the rows from my internet sales table. It's kind of like in t-sql, if you write select star from table name, this evaluate is doing the exact same thing, but with less clicks, right? It'll return any table. So when you go to search about filter or treat as, let's take treat as for example. If you go look up the definition of treat as, so treat as returns a table. So we could do this, and then we can say calendar year, and all it's gonna do is return a single column table. If we go in here, I think we can do this. Let me see. If we do that, right? So the more items I add to my treat as, the more that list will grow. And so I could test out to see if my treat as is returning exactly what I expect. And it works for any of the functions that return a table. This one, if I wanted to test out filter. So if I was trying to filter the product table and only return a particular color, let's say red, for example, I can actually see the results by using this evaluate. Let's run that. And these are all red, right? If I change this color to black or white, you can see these are all the black products. And maybe I want to count them. So we can do this, because count rows accepts a table as its input. We run this, And so it's saying this expression specified in the query is not a valid table expression because I'm trying to return a table. What I need to do is use a constructor here to transform this scalar value, this expression, into a table with results. So you can see now I have 133 black products, right? It's very similar to I'm getting excited. Calm down, breathe. It's very similar to a SQL language, right? It's just different keywords. So let's say I wanted to return the rows from the internet sales table, and then I want to order them by the order date. Okay, here we go. Just ran it. It's going to order them by default, and then we'll switch this up and see which is the highest one. And now we can see we just reversed the order. So that statement, that query is saying select star from internet sales order by order date. So what if I want to kind of filter this and start like a greater than or equal to? There's another little keyword called start at. And so I'm going to start at, so you can see you have what, 111,000 rows. So I'm going to start at 202161. And we're going to get rid of the descending June 1st, 2021. So we should get only 5,000 rows. And then you can see it's starting at June 1st, and then it goes all the way out to my last value in the table. There's some other nuances to start at, and you need to go read about them in the documentation. It's amazing. You may be thinking to yourself, well, Patrick, those are simple, but what if I wanna add a where clause, include a measure, and do an aggregation? Let me show you. Let's say you're writing a measure for the first time and you wanna test it out. We'll do something really simple. So we're gonna say define, and we're gonna define this on the internet sales table because this new query view will let me add it. And so I'm gonna call this M1, measure one, equal. I forgot one very important keyword, y'all. That's measure. That's why we saw that. And look, it's saying, hey, you're about to do something. And so I'm gonna do something really simple. I'm gonna say sum, and then let's see, freight. And now I'm gonna get rid of everything because we're gonna do some stuff here. And now if I wanna see what the sum of freight is, I can again use my table constructor, use M1, because that's the name of my measure. And now if I run this, it's gonna return the total of freight. And now maybe I want to see freight for this year. I wanna aggregate it by the years that I'm displaying or for the months in that year. How would you write that query? You can actually use this to test out, you know, what's gonna be displayed back in the Power BI report view. So I'm gonna use summarize columns, and it's saying, hey, I need to know what columns you're gonna group by. So me, I'm gonna do it by month. And then the next thing it's saying, if you pay attention, I can add multiple group by columns, but I'm gonna just filter the table. So this is basically the where clause. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna write me a little treat as, I want 2021. That's the only year I wanna return, and I'm gonna do this by calendar year. So I'm gonna return all the months for 2021. And then if you look at the syntax, it's saying, here's my group by columns, here's how I'm gonna filter it. Now an expression. So you gotta name the expression that you wanna return. So I'm gonna do a little escape here. And then what I'm gonna do is say total freight M1. Boom, that should be what I need. So let's go ahead and run this. So you can see we only have data up to June for 2021. But if I switch this and say, give me 2020, do that, you can see I get every month. Right now, if I want to, I can add this to my model. But basically behind the scenes, what it's doing is, because there's a relationship between internet sales and calendar, if I looked at the SQL itself, it's joining on the key on the relationship that I have. And then it's saying where year equals 2020. So if you think about it under the covers, if you think about how this DAX query is being written, it's just SQL. And if you put it in the perspective of that, my buddy Phil Seamark told me this, you can solve a lot of your DAX challenges. Okay. All right. What do you think? Are you writing query expressions? It's a great way to test out the measures that you're writing in your Power BI desktop, in the measures that you create in DAX. Are you using this today? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about DAX and data modeling Power BI, I'm sure there's a video flying above my head. And as always, Matt and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.